Let's start by explaining what a hypothesis is. Though there are many ways to define it, the most intuitive one is the following. A hypothesis is an idea that can be tested. This is not the formal definition of the term. However, it explains the point very well. So, if I tell you that apples in New York are expensive, this is an idea, or a statement, which, however, is not testable until I have something to compare it with. If I define expensive as any price higher than $1.75 per pound, then it immediately becomes a hypothesis. There are some ideas that cannot be considered hypotheses, though. For example, if we ask, would the USA do better or worse under the Trump administration compared to the Clinton administration? Statistically speaking, there is no sufficient data to test this idea. Therefore, it cannot be a hypothesis of a statistical test. Thus, it is more likely to be a topic of another discipline. Conversely, in statistics, we can only compare U.S. presidencies that have already been completed. For example, we can examine the Obama and Bush administrations, as we have data on both. Okay, there are 7 steps in data-driven decision-making. First, we formulate a hypothesis. Once we have done this, we will have to find the right test for it, considering the probability distribution of the data we are working with. The third step is to specify the significance level of the test. The fourth thing we have to do is to state the decision rule. Then, we need to gather the data and execute the test. The sixth step is to accept or reject the test from a statistical perspective. And finally, we have to use the statistical insight obtained to make an economic or investment decision. As a rule of thumb, when doing hypothesis testing, there are 2 hypotheses that are made: the null hypothesis, denoted by H0, and the alternative hypothesis, denoted by H1 or HA. The null hypothesis is the one to be tested, and the alternative is the opposite case. For example, we can have the following. Null hypothesis. The mean financial analyst salary in the USA is $113,000. While the alternative, H1, would be, the mean financial analyst salary in the USA is not $113,000. Now, you would want to check if $113,000 is close enough to the population mean. If this is true, you would accept the null hypothesis. Otherwise, you would reject the null hypothesis. The concept of the null hypothesis is similar to the principle, innocent until proven guilty. We assume that the mean salary is $113,000, and we try to prove otherwise. It is important to note that the test outcomes refer to the population parameter, rather than the sample statistic. As such, the result we obtain is for the population. Another crucial consideration is that, generally, the researcher is trying to reject the null hypothesis. Think about the null hypothesis as the status quo, and the alternative is the change, or innovation, that challenges the status quo. In our example, the status quo is the mean financial analyst salary is $113,000, which we are challenging. All right, this will do for now. Thanks for watching.